Well, Mitch, congratulations. The 2018 Magarey Medallist back-to-back. How's it feeling the second time around?
Yeah, certainly wasn't expected, as wasn't last year, but very humbled to win it again, and something I'll cherish very closely to myself.
What's the feeling like this year compared to last year?
Obviously, we're playing finals this year, so no beers tonight and on the waters, so looking forward to the next few weeks to come.
What were your expectations coming into the count? Because obviously there was a lot of talk about even your teammate Matty Panos, and I know myself, I even thought you might be the first pair from the same club to perhaps win it together.
Yeah, there was a lot of talk going on during the week about Noss and myself, you know, maybe tying it up, but I certainly thought Noss had a better year than I did, and he was my favourite, as long as and the same as Little as well, so he had a great year, but yeah, very humbled and you know, privileged to win it.
And now you join one of the Nord greats in Gary McIntosh in winning two, and he won back-to-back as well in 94 and 95, so that's pretty special to be alongside someone like Macca.
Yeah, obviously Gary's, you know, one of the club greats, 300-game player, and if I can be half the player he was, you know, I'll be going pretty well. So very, very humbled to be in the likes of Gary.
Few similarities between the two as well, left-footers and pretty rugged midfielders.
Yeah, hopefully, I hope I got him in the looks department, but I think he had me in the physical side of things. He was a bit bigger than me, but yeah, if I can play sort of his style of footy, hard at it, and you know, good ball user, then I'll be happy with that.
How did you assess you? You got out of the blocks really well, really strong start, then probably petered off a little bit in the middle, and then finished off strong again.
Yeah, I think it was very similar to last year. You know, body just gets weary during the middle of the year, and if you have a few good games, you start copping a little bit more attention game day. And you know, I probably wasn't handling it as well as I probably could have or should have. And my work rate dropped off, and you know, towards the back end of the year, I just really wanted to get back to basics and you know, work on my spread and contest the ball. And yeah, I think by the second half of the year, it wasn't as good as the first, but I was starting to get back to some reasonable form.
Really nice moment tonight to share it with your dad, Chris. Obviously, we know his documented battle with MND, and lovely for him to be here tonight with you.
Yeah, obviously, it's awesome, you know, just to have Dad there to experience it with me. And, you know, he's obviously very proud, but I wouldn't be half the player and person I am today without his support and leadership, you know, through my whole life. So, obviously, very special to have him here tonight.
One of the great memories, and I know I spoke to you with it when you played your 100th game, was making your senior debut in the C grade with the Athelstan Raggies, and the same game happened to be his 200th. What are your memories from that day?
I remember just getting a photo with my younger brother and old man and my pop, and it was the three generations, and we tried to find the photo for that week, and I couldn't find it anywhere, and I only just got it the last couple of weeks, and it's something really good to look back on. But yeah, he got first best, I got second best that day, so I think it was my first beer in the change rooms down there, so it was a really awesome memory and something I'll cherish for forever.
Most definitely you will, as you will probably the selfie, and you're trying to teach him to take one there after the count tonight, which was a nice moment for you too.
Yeah, he's almost mastered the selfie. He almost takes one everywhere he goes now, so it's a bit of a running joke. He posts it on Facebook wherever he goes, so it's quite hilarious. He put one up before the night, actually, and yeah, I had a good laugh about that, so he's quite humorous.
And also, no doubt, you want to pay tribute to the females in your life as well, your mum and your partner, Nicole.
Yeah, obviously Mum's had a massive part in my life as well, and she's brought me up to the person I am now and the player as well. And yeah, my partner Nicole, she's been a great support this year, obviously going through you know, what I have with Dad and that, and also her family as well. So I'm so lucky to have her with me as well.
And just before we finish, huge game, obviously, Sunday, the second semi-final against Woodville West Torrens. How are the boys? Obviously you've had a week off to get Cherry right.
Yeah, we had our first sort of main training session last night leading up, and the boys, you know, we were on fire. The boys were training really well. The voice was up. The energy was there, and, you know, we're just really looking forward to getting back out in the park and coming up in form Eagle side. So hopefully if we can bring our pressure and our heat, you know, hopefully not many sides can go with us.
Mitch, thank you very much for your time on SANFL TV, and once again, congratulations on being the 2018 Magarey Medallist. That's back-to-back. Well done.
Thank you very much.